Coming up, we take a look at Azure Synapse Analytics, our next-gen Azure SQL Data Warehouse solution that delivers limitless analytics and on-demand query compute at scale as a single service. Now, we're going to show you the end-to-end experience of building and deploying rich analytics scenarios and how you can automatically generate predictive models and much more. Today, I'm joined by John McIntyre from the Azure Synapse Analytics team at Microsoft, no stranger to mechanics. Welcome back to the show.
Hi, Jeremy. It's great to be back.
So last time you were here, we actually had a look at Azure SQL Data Warehouse Gen 2 and how powerful that platform is for analyzing massive data sets. And more recently, we actually had Charles Federson on the show that really went through the modern data warehouse solution pattern and really brought together the full data and analytics stack. But how do things evolve now with Azure Synapse Analytics?
So with our solution pattern, we were really focused on taking best of breed services and connecting them so that you could deliver end-to-end analytic solutions that were not possible with traditional enterprise data warehousing solutions. You could do ETL, bring the data into your data lake, and from there you could take advantage of our big data processing engines, data warehouse, and also visualize your data. That said, we know there was a certain degree of complexity associated with wiring these services together. You need to right-size the services for your needs, and it's not trivial to monitor health, enforce security, and manage networking across all of these technology pieces. So to help with that, we've been really focused on delivering an end-to-end analytics platform that combines all the capabilities that you need for limitless analytics into a single service. And that is Azure Synapse Analytics, the evolution of our Azure SQL Data Warehouse service. So with Azure Synapse in a single unified service, we give you a broader and fully integrated set of capabilities. Not only do we give you ETL, but we've made hybrid data ingestion and orchestration easier. We give you secure self-service enterprise analytics through our data warehouse. We provide AI and big data processing. And we've even added more capabilities such as efficient compute power on demand for queries, as well as end-to-end monitoring, management, and security in a unified experience. All of this leverages our limitless Azure Data Lake Storage service for any type of data. And through our Open Data Initiative, you can bring data from other systems into Azure Synapse Analytics.
So this is super powerful because you can actually onboard your organization a lot faster. You're removing really the integration work that has to assemble all those core pieces that you were talking about. It's all turnkey now. And it's really got all the intelligent analytics all as a platform out of the box. And we also kind of do all the tuning to meet the needs of any workload.
Yeah, that's right. It really supports any data and any analytics at limitless scale. Azure Synapse Analytics eliminates the divide between the data lake and the data warehouse. And of course, this is an open platform that integrates a broad set of services, including Power BI, Microsoft Dynamics, Azure Machine Learning, Azure Data Share, and of course, your existing applications and data platforms that you're using today.
So how do data teams actually interact with the service?
Yeah, that's one of the really unique aspects of Azure Synapse. We deliver all of these capabilities within a single workspace environment. So teams of data engineers, data scientists, and analysts can use and collaborate on the same data. So for example, as a data analyst, I can access capabilities that allow me to explore and analyze data. I can develop SQL scripts, and if I'm a data scientist, additionally build machine learning models and generate predictions. And as a data engineer, I can easily build and orchestrate data pipeline.
And of course, you can monitor and manage the entire service. So as a service, it not only removes the silos kind of between the different data sets and data sources, but also removes the silos between people so they can work more efficiently together. But can you show us how this works?
Yeah, absolutely. It's really easy to get started with Azure Synapse. You just have to go to the Azure portal and create a workspace. You can see here that it only takes a few steps to create a workspace. I'll go and define my subscription, assign a resource group, and I give that workspace a name. I'm going to use John Mac WS1. We'll keep our default location, select our storage account and file system, and it's just that easy. Now I can review and create that workspace. The workspace encapsulates capabilities that I showed you to build and deploy your enterprise analytics solutions.
So it looks super easy to provision, but how would I bring data then into the platform?
Yeah, so because Azure Synapse is ODI or Open Data Initiative aware, any data that gets pushed into a data lake in ODI format, Azure Synapse can work with. And for all other enterprise data, as a data engineer, you'd come into Synapse Studio and you dive into Orchestrate. This allows both hybrid data ingestion and orchestration. First, to bring data in, we'll need to create a linked connection. I can do this from the Manage tab in Azure Synapse Studio. I can go and click New, and New will allow me to create that new link service. Azure Synapse offers more than 85 enterprise connectors for a variety of sources, including on-premises systems, SaaS applications, as well as other clouds. It's like ETL without all the hassle.
Okay, so now you've linked everything up. How do I actually bring data in?
Yeah, so Azure Synapse will provide both code-free as well as code-first experiences for doing data transformations as well as data wrangling. If I look into the pipeline hub, I can modify an existing flow from Azure Synapse Studio. Here, if I select my clean and enrich data flow and tab over, I can add an additional transformation to this existing data pipeline. I'm going to go ahead and select plus, and plus allows me to do additional transformations as well as schema modifiers. So here I can easily add a derived column to my data flow. And if I select this, it does the heavy lifting to automatically generate the transformation code and deploy that to fully manage scale-out clusters.
So this is a really graphical and intuitive experience here, where distributed team members can really share and interact with common sets of pipelines and data sets. But why don't we continue moving up the left nav and also show what you can do under develop? Because I imagine this is really where the core of Azure Synapse Analytics is, because it came from Azure SQL Data Warehouse.
That's right. SQL is really one of the core and most popular enterprise analytics languages. This lights up data visualization, and the enterprise data warehouse has traditionally been the platform powering this. Synapse extends the capabilities of SQL Data Warehouse, so we're building on the performance, elasticity, security, robustness, and scale of the service to give your analyst a single source of truth for enterprise analytics.
Cool. So it's been optimized then and extended with even more capabilities. And after our years of running massive data and compute services, all of that's even better now. So why don't we switch gears though and talk about how you'd integrate an existing set of data?
Yeah, this is really where our data lake integration comes into play. You can extend your SQL analytics directly to the data lake to analyze data without moving or copying the data. You can use these capabilities with your allocated compute resources, but we've also added a completely new serverless query on-demand modality to give you the horsepower you need at the exact moment that you're running these queries. Let me show you how SQL Analytics works integrated with Azure Data Lake in Synapse Studio. So here you can see I'm in the data pane, and I have my storage accounts, my databases, and my data sets. I've pre-selected a set of files here that are in my data lake. I have over 300 terabytes of data here in my data lake, and I want to start to explore that data and see what's in some of these files.
Okay.
If I right-click on these files and say open in SQL script, Synapse will automatically generate a SQL statement to query over this data. You'll notice at the top here that I'm attached to SQL on demand, which means I haven't provisioned any pools or resources to process this query. I'm running completely serverless, so I'm only going to pay for the one query that I run here.
All right, so now you're going to run the query, and it's pretty awesome because now we have a query service. In this case, it's not just looking over a database, but a data lake.
That's right. So we're taking the power of SQL and we're bringing it to the data lake. And so if we go back to our query results here, you can see that Synapse has finished the query, and Synapse has also automatically detected the schema of these files. You can see all of the column headers populated in the results pane. I can also start to visualize some of this data if I click on chart. I can see I have options there with chart type, X axis column, Y axis column. I can start to play with and visualize that data all within one place.
So that makes it super easy then to explore your data now.
Yeah, that's right. And now I can take this data and I can load it into a data warehouse, in which case I would use provisioned resources versus my on-demand resources so that I can meet the performance expectations that I might expect in an enterprise data warehouse.
Makes total sense. So now it's really great that you can actually switch between the different query modes depending on which workload you're actually using and working against. So it looks like a complete unification now between the data lake and the data warehouse.
That's right. And by enabling SQL on-demand through a query service, combined with provisioned resources, you can apply whichever compute modality is optimal for your workload, such as ad hoc query exploration or some of our enterprise analytics use cases, such as dashboards and reporting.
So this is going to be used then regardless of where the data is stored, but how would a data scientist then use Synapse?
Yeah, that's a great question. As I mentioned, AI and ML are built into Azure Synapse. Synapse provides a Spark-based analytics runtime that supports multiple languages commonly used for data processing or machine learning. You can use Python, Java, R, and even .NET. We've added .NET support for Spark for our broad community of .NET developers. So if I navigate over to the data view, here I have the same set of data that I was processing with SQL. If I select one of these files and right click, I have the option to open in a notebook. I'm going to select open in the notebook. And here Azure Synapse will automatically generate code in Python for me to get started with this data. It's important to note that this is a completely serverless Spark platform.
So in this case, there's no provisioned resource being used here.
That's right. Let me switch back to the analyze view. And here you can see a notebook that I've created earlier. I'm using Python in this example to train a model against my data in the data lake. And soon with Azure Synapse, you'll be able to invoke predictive models in SQL. If we look at the SQL script, we can see how this works. Here you can see I'm using a familiar SQL statement to invoke an in-database model to output a predicted value on each record in the result set.
Okay, this is really great. This is probably the first time I've ever seen machine learning combined with SQL.
Yeah, this really brings predictive analytics to SQL so that any SQL developer can do richer set of analytics just by writing SQL statements. So if we go and we run this query here, we'll see we're running our prediction right on top of this data, and we're getting the output of that prediction in our result pane.
So what's here, this data set here?
Yeah, so this data set is the New York taxi data. Mm-hmm. And what we're doing is we're predicting whether a driver is going to receive a tip or not. You'll see in the first column in the result pane, the labeled tip, it says it's binary. Yes or no, are you going to get a tip? That is what the model is outputting. And there you see just through SQL, we've invoked that model and we're scoring that data as a result.
Very cool. And this is a workspace, and it can also be linked with Power BI right from Synapse Studio. And you can develop dashboards and reports from all your data, including the data that we loaded into the warehouse, as well as the output of the predictive models that we just saw. So it's really awesome that we've integrated the experience for your data scientists, data analysts, and also data engineers.
Yeah, and this is really just a first look at Azure Synapse. We're bringing end-to-end monitoring for your entire analytics solution with Azure Synapse, and we'll also be integrating with Azure DevOps for application lifecycle management.
So I know a lot of people are probably using Azure SQL Data Warehouse right now. What do they have to do to bring their data into this?
That's the great thing. If you're using Azure SQL Data Warehouse today, you're all set. All of these will be released as new capabilities on the service, and they will start to roll out soon for existing customers.
This is really awesome stuff, the work that you and the team have done to build this all out, but where would I go to learn more?
All you have to do is you go to aka.ms/synapse to learn more and sign up today.
Thanks, John, and of course, keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech updates. If you haven't already, hit subscribe today. And from the Bellevue Microsoft Technology Center, thanks for watching, we'll see you next time.